The Lucky Pants has received a simple but extremely powerful buff that makes any hand cannons that interact with it very overpowered for a short time frame. And I welcome the Lucky Pants supremacy, since the exotics look like they were taken from the 100 plus John Wayne films and then chucked into some sci-fi shooter because the game can't tell what it wants to be half the time. And with that, I have a build that is one of the most useful but also outright overpowered hand cannon builds to net your hands on if you ever play Gambit or any content that has taken in it. I'm talking non-stop debuffs and personal buffs that will make Oryx double take on the obscene amount of brilliant being conducted. At the same time, the build will allow users to opt in and out in terms of what mods and weapons you want to use, as any hand cannon can be slotted in to fit your personal choice. If this is starting to sound appealing and you want to obliterate any taken you come across, then gather around the campfire, as I have a story to give you. Before we head in, if you enjoyed the video, then do leave a like and sub for more content like this in the future, I would really appreciate it. For the subclass, we will be using Way of the Trapper for his simplicity of his super and how his abilities are strongly focused around solo play. Now with the build, we want to maximize Lucky Pants damage, and for this you want to utilize both subclasses and the Particle Deconstruction mod where you can. Since Particle is linked in via the Fusion Rifle, we can easily set ourselves up to apply the 40% debuff whenever. This is where I wanted to apply the same thing via our super, and found the Way of the Trapper is the best option to stick with. I wanted to have two ways of applying debuffs to combatants depending on who I was facing and for what reason, such as using my super on bosses with large amounts of health and use my fusion with the mod on anything else. This way I can maximize and control how I use my weapons and buffs accordingly without needing to panic because I messed up on the sequence to achieve this. Way the Trapper is simple in what it does. A vanishing step allows me to go invisible when I dodge and is very useful for the most chaotic environments I end up in. Dead Falls allows my super to anchor itself wherever it's located in and will last longer and has extra range. These are really the only two sub perks you're going to be using the most within the subclass, as nothing else is really that much needed, nor do you need a wide amount of synergy involved. You will be using your grenades of course, and you will be using a lot of elemental rods in the process, but those will be linked back to weapon usage and increasing efficiency across how much damage you'll be able to pull. Also to note, I chose to avoid Way of the Pathfinder as the super requires you to constantly proc it and is more suited for team setups. You can use it if you want to play a more team pivotal role, but I would advise against it and rely more on the weapons at hand rather than subclass themselves. For weaponry, we have some flexibility when it comes to picking the primary weapon of use. You do not need to use Malfeasance within the setup shown, however I would advise picking it because of its ease of use and large magazine size that you won't fully get through while the buff is gone, but will help when being surrounded by other combatants as well. With the weapon and Lucky Pants together, we are capable of turning and taking enemies inside out with a quick burst from our weapon, and the increased damage we'll be gaining as well. On top of that, our Zotic also rolls with the perk called Taken Predator, which increases the amount of damage we do against any taken combatants even more. Combining everything we got against a taken boss, the damage produced will be godly and can make you an ultimate taken boss slayer within any content you play in. Alternatively, we can always swap our weapon for Crimson if we want to build up our Lucky Pants stats quickly, and also heal on kills, or we can swap out for the Hawkmoon for overall more damage, or the Last Word, which is considered the best hand cannon to use when pairing with Lucky Pants. Simply pick and choose what you like, as the results would be generally the same. For a secondary, I went with the No Composure Fusion Rifle with Heating Up and Reservoir Burst, and ideally pairing for taking on bosses, mini bosses, and clearing out combatants of all types. Now, Null isn't the only Void Fusion you can pick, as you can use alternatives such as Glide Chasm or Courier's Force, but let's be honest here, they both suck and don't offer the greatest selection of perks to use in PvE, so Null in general offers the best of the two. Although Null may lack RNG rolls, it's still considered one of the best rapid fire frames to use from DPS, ad clearing, to even cutting your lawn. The weapon and perk combination make it a great pairing to use for this season in general, and also makes it even greater for this build with its wide uses of elemental wells that will be both producing and benefiting from here on out. If you have the weapon, I would highly recommend you use it within the build, but if not, like I mentioned earlier, you can use alternatives except from the Glide Chasm, which doesn't exist anymore except if you already have your collections. Lastly, you could also swap out the use of fusions and use grenade launchers instead, such as Awing's Maw or Deafening Whisper. Grenade launchers have a great blast radius and can take out a majority of combatants in one shot if a direct hit lands. You'll lose out on the deconstruction mod debuff though, but this will be entirely down to you which is best for you. For heavy, I've chosen to use the Beringer's Memory, Grenade Launcher, with Spike Grenades, Clown Cartridge and Auto Loading Holster. The perfect Void Heavy to own that will seriously allow you to pull out the raw damage when you empty your mag. Applying the debuff and then getting the Fondle Might buff active could actually make this one of the most highest damaging legendary grenade launchers in game and could have its own usage in certain types of endgame content to melt bosses. However, this will vary on who you face and if you land all your shots in a given time frame. Of course, I like to use this one once I have emptied my primary and want to carry on dumping more rounds in a combatant just for good measure and for overkill. I would recommend you try and nab one like the one currently shown, just for safekeeping. For stats, we'll be using elemental mods a lot throughout the build to cover key stats and also grant us even greater benefits. Two areas to focus on will be the discipline and intellect area, with mobility also playing a small role as well. Discipline will help with clearing out combatants of all types, but also allows to trigger the Fondle Might buff for increasing damage. Fondle Might will be helping all of our weapons available as it's a global buff, which means it will stack with the Lucky Pants buff for even more nutty damage output. At the same time, we do have the Elemental Armors mod that can produce a whirl upon void kills, and the Reaping Rollmaker mod that states that it will allow users to produce a guaranteed whirl upon dodging or using your class ability and then getting a kill, which I found to be very useful knowing I'll be getting one straight away after a weapon kill. Now I do have a few mods that will be sustaining the other mods around so they can be more useful overall. The Powerful Friends mod will grant us a plus 20 in mobility, which is linked into our dodge ability, so we can recover the energy for this area much quicker than normal, including the wells that will drop as well. And then we have the Grenade Kickstart mod that will help with recovering my grenade energy a bit quicker if everything goes as planned. For Intellect, we have the Hands-On, Dynamo and Intellect mods available to support this one area, but we can add in mods such as Frontal Wisdom to the mix, but only if you have enough space available to do so. The Frontal Wisdom is a great mod to use as you're getting a gradually growing boost of super energy while playing normally, and this can go a long way when paired with an intellect focused build. As my build doesn't rely on intellect to make this whole build work, I can get away with not adding it in this time round, but in the future, I would definitely go ahead and use the mod to save me some time and space. Now with the stats, weapons and subclass section covered, the next section will break down how it plays overall with pros and cons. For starters, let's take a look at the mods we are using first before we head in. Head, we have Discipline, Hands-On, Dynamo and Elemental Armors mod. Arm, we have Intellect, Grenade Kickstart and Fastball mod. Chest, we have Discipline, Concussive Damage times 2 and Font of Might mod. Leg, we have Minor Mobility, Fusion Scavenger, Invigoration and Powerful Friends mod. A cloak, we have Minor Discipline, Particle Deconstruction and the Reaping World Maker mod. For a heavy taken focus build, this build will pack a punch against all adversaries you face. Now to keep it simple, Malfeasance is great on its own against any taken combatants you face, as you're going to be applying that extra damage to them compared to facing a Fallen or Cabal instead. This makes taking on the Prophecy boss, or Gambit boss, or any taken themed boss a breeze for building up sustainable damage over long periods. On top of that, it also has 20 in the magazine and also has infinite ammo, which makes it even more absurd to use. However, upgrading this weapon further by providing a unique build around it can make taking on the Taken and anyone else even more smoother on your end. Applying the Fondle Might buff will grant us an extra 25% weapon boost upon collecting the elemental well via our weapons, grenades or simply dodging, thanks to the Reaping Wellmaker mod. That damage buff can be refreshed multiple times in a short time frame as long as we activate the correct mods that are needed. We then have the Particle Deconstruction mod for that 40% debuff application on all targets, which makes all of our weapons do even more damage on top of the global buff we have. So now Malfeasance is becoming a bit of a golden gun tier weapon, with Lucky Pants boosting its performance even more. But this does not end here. We then lastly have the Tether option, which will provide us with a 30% extra debuff on top of the debuff we already have. However, and sadly, Tether and Particle do not stack anymore, so you can't get the best of both worlds and absolutely destroy that one taken captain that refuses to die. Does this make the rest of the build obsolete though? Nope, not one bit, as you can still pull off a hefty amount of damage against a combatant depending on the debuff applied. Plus, they both have their pros to each other when being used. Particle is a seasonal mod which everyone will be using at some point, so you don't need to always worry about needing to apply it onto a combatant to get the full effects going. A Tevin now is a one and done super that you can use whenever you are ready, and the fact that it lasts so long and adds a suppressive effect to all targets affected means you can deal with different combatants one at a time without fear. This is a really great setup for all players, as all items shown can be obtained in game, but most importantly, you don't need to have the same weaponry or mods to achieve the following. You can swap out your hand cannon for something else and take out all the mods and still get the same effect with little effort. This is perfect, as player option to pick and choose is still available for those that can complement what's being missed. So if you ever land your hand on the Lucky Pants and Malfeasians combo, and you want to absolutely wreck that one pesty taken combatant, or ruin the livelihood of that one dreg, be sure to give this build a try, it will do you well. So if you enjoyed the video, then please leave a like and a sub, and also follow me on Twitter to keep up to date with Destiny content if you did that type of stuff, link is down below. But once again, thanks for stopping by, and I'll see you on the next one.